Buenos dias. Today we are talking about how to lose fat without feeling deprived. Because the feeling of deprivation is so often the reason why folks aren't able to lose fat in the first place. And also, if they do, it can be the reason why they're not able to maintain said fat loss. Now, you know me, and I'm all about taking a lifestyle approach to this stuff, a sustainable approach to fat loss. So let's unpack this. I think that it's helpful to think about fat loss and deprivation or restriction sort of like sex, because sex and food are both basic human needs. Human evolution can be boiled down into four super simple words: turn calories into babies. That is human evolution in a nutshell on the most fundamental level. We are driven to seek out food first and foremost, because if we don't eat, we die. And once the food box is checked, we're driven to have sex and procreate. Now, humans are not inherently monogamous. However, many of us choose monogamy. On the other hand, some folks are in open relationships, some are into polyamory and all sorts of things. But as of right now, societally speaking, the vast majority of people choose to be in monogamous relationships, or at least they verbalize that that's what they want. Infidelity happens, of course, but let's put that aside for a second. You know, because I mention it often on the pod, that a calorie deficit is required in order to lose fat. There is no way around this. Having said that, there are absolutely better and worse ways to go about creating a calorie deficit from a behavior and sustainability standpoint. But at the end of the day, a calorie deficit must be present in order to lose fat. So, saying that we want to lose fat, implementing the required actions, and then feeling deprived or restricted of certain food options and or amounts is like saying that we want a monogamous relationship and then feeling deprived or restricted of sexual partners. Now, it's worth mentioning that the way that you structure and set up your diet is crucial, because if it's set up poorly, you're going to feel quote unquote deprived or restricted no matter what, simply because your body does have physiological needs via certain proteins, fatty acids, vitamin minerals, etc., and it's important that you provide those things. It's also vital to take into account your specific psychology in regards to food and things like meal frequency, meal timing, meal preferences, macronutrients, digestion, etc. However, once you individualize your nutritional approach for you specifically, deprivation or restriction is just a perspective at that point. Because if we feel deprived in a monogamous relationship, we don't have to be monogamous. It's 100% our choice. However, we can't then expect to have all of the benefits of a monogamous relationship if we're not willing to play by monogamous rules. Just like, if we feel deprived with the nutritional approach for fat loss that we're taking, we don't have to lose fat. It's 100% our choice. However, we can't then expect to have all of the benefits of losing fat and getting healthier if we're not willing to play by the fat loss rules. I rarely eat dairy because it flares up my arthritis and gives me joint pain. So I have a choice to make. I can choose to eat dairy and experience pain, or I can choose to skip dairy and be pain-free. If I choose to skip dairy because I'd prefer to be pain-free, but then I simultaneously focus on how deprived I am of dairy as a result, that doesn't add up because I chose it. I can't have both. Hence, the perspective that we take in regards to deprivation or restriction is fundamental. In a monogamous relationship, I can choose to focus on all of the people that I quote unquote can't have sex with, or I can focus on the person that I can have sex with. Exact same relationship setup, drastically different choice of perspectives, and as a result, a drastically different experience. Oftentimes, folks will say that they want to eat healthier and lose fat, but then as soon as they start the process, they choose to focus on all of the food and/or food amounts that they quote unquote can't eat on a daily basis, instead of all of the foods that they quote unquote can eat. Now, as an aside, there is no food that we can or can't eat when it comes to fat loss, but portions absolutely do become a thing, and food selection is a massive factor in regards to fat loss success, primarily because of how different foods impact satiety. Also, you can just as easily shift your focus to all of the amazing things that you're gaining by losing fat and getting healthier. Better body composition, improved sense of well-being, your clothes are fitting better, your friends are showering you with compliments, your blood pressure goes down, your hormones normalize, you have more energy, you're mentally more clear, you're emotionally more stable. I could go on for ages, but no, we say, I'm so deprived. So if we want monogamy, we have to play by the monogamous rules. And similarly, if we want fat loss, we have to play by fat loss rules, because the fat loss process takes what it takes. And so the question becomes, are you willing to consistently do what's required? And if the answer is yes, cool. And if the answer is no, that's also cool. But being upset about what is required to achieve fat loss is a trap that I see some folks fall into. For example, wishing that fat loss was easier or different than it actually is like wishing that a day had 25, 26, or 27 hours in it. It just doesn't. The laws of nature and life are what they are. And so wishing them to be another way is just a complete waste of time because we can't change it. You can think about it like gravity. The pull on the earth is what the pull on the earth is. We don't have the power to shift it. And so there's no use sitting around wishing or wanting it to be different than it is. Now, maybe you're still like, Marcus, I don't agree. Restriction isn't perspective-based. I experience it as something else. Okay, in that case, consider this. When you're feeling restricted or deprived of X foods or Y way of eating, be sure that at the very least, you acknowledge both sides of your situation. For example, I feel restricted because I feel as though I can't eat all of the pizza, ice cream, and burgers that I feel like eating, being that fat loss is my goal. Got it. That's one side. The other side is, in what ways are eating all of the pizza, ice cream, and burgers that you feel like eating on a day-to-day basis restricting you? For example, how do those foods impact your energy levels and sense of well-being? Probably not in all that beneficial of a way. That is restricting your energy and well-being. How do those foods impact your body composition? They are amazing at fattening us up, and so how is that restricting you? How do those foods impact your digestion? No one's digestion is better eating pizza, burgers, and ice cream. So how is that restricting you? So if you choose to take this whole I feel so restricted and deprived mindset, just be sure that you look at both sides of the coin, because nothing in life has 100% downside and 0% upside and vice versa. But back to my preferred perspective on all of this stuff. If you are feeling deprived or restricted, you can go through this super simple line of questioning to clear things up for yourself. One, why do you feel deprived or restricted? So first and foremost, are your nutritional choices themselves providing your body with what it needs so that your physiological bases are covered? Secondly, have you structured your approach in a way that fits your specific lifestyle, preferences, goals, priorities, etc.? Now, if you're still feeling deprived or restricted, what are you choosing to focus on. All of the things that you can do, eat, the sense of well-being benefits, feeling better, boosting your confidence, etc., or just everything that you're quote-unquote missing out on or can't do. It's sort of like that glass half full or half empty dealio. How are you choosing to see and view your choices? Also, this is a really important takeaway. Everyone eventually gets to a point in time where the lifestyle trade-offs to, say, get leaner are no longer worth the benefits of getting leaner itself. And that is a super important aspect to stay aware of. For example, I'm in the 10-ish percent body fat range right now, and I don't want to get leaner, but let's pretend that I was entertaining that desire for a second. If the nutrition and lifestyle trade-offs that I'd need to make in order to get to, say, 8% body fat are not worth the actual result of achieving 8% body fat, I'm going to feel deprived and restricted because the input is not worth the output, or essentially what's required is not worth the result for me. Now, there are so many different examples of this that pop up every single day in life, but a super simple one is, if you go into a store and you see a shirt that you like and you're like, ooh, I think I might buy that. And then you look at the price, and in your perspective, the price is not worth how much you like the shirt, you don't buy it. Same deal in regards to achieving further results. The input needs to be worth the output. And as soon as you get to a point where more input isn't worth more output for you specifically, congrats, you've reached your goal. That's awesome. For me right now, that is 10-ish percent body fat. That's my sweet spot. And once you find yours, you can hang out there and live an awesome, quote unquote, balanced life as far as how your priorities stack up. So the real take home here is choice, choice, choice. What are you choosing to do? But far more importantly, how are you choosing to perceive said choices? If you're interested in applying for one-on-one nutritional coaching and or workout design with me, you can click the link in the description below or head on over to n1fitness.com/coaching. Instagram, I'm at n1fitness. TikTok, I'm at the n1fitness. And on YouTube, I'm at Marcus Sidhu. Feel free to leave us a review on your favorite podcast platform, if you'd like, of course. And be sure to hit the subscribe button. Thanks so much for tuning in. I hope that you found this episode useful, and I will catch you on the next one. See ya.